Through time and space hast thou journeyed unto me, as I knew thou wouldst. We are the word of the Mother. We, who were once called Minfilia. Much time hath passed for thee since the bloody banquet, since I hearkened to her word. Mother, Hydaelyn guided me towards Ishtola and Thancred, that I might be swept up in their flow and delivered unto the ethereal sea. There, adrift and alone, her voice silent once more, I prayed for those we had lost, for those we can yet save. To her I would make an offering. We speak now with one voice, one will. One word. Unto thee we bequeath the most precious of gifts, the truth which lieth at the heart of this world. Thus do we beseech thee once more. Hear, feel, think. Before there was life in the depths of the ethereal sea, light and dark did once dwell as one. But the darkness coveted power, and the balance was broken. Thus was I forced to banish him unto the distant heavens, to forever remain apart. A moon bound. In sundering the star did we cry out, and the barriers twixt planes chanced to falter. Across 10 and 3 were we then divided, reflections of the source, each possessed of a shard. Zodiac longeth to be made whole. For his restoration, for his resurrection, his servants labor without cease. They seek to tear down the barriers which surround the source. Thus do they rejoice in their ardor, in your calamities, for each marks a rejoining. Seven times have they succeeded. Seven times hath the darkness grown stronger. Seven times have I failed. The Asians, cannot be suffered to continue. This is my final. The crystal's power is all but spent. With what remains, I will return you to the shore of the ethereal sea. Blessed children, go forth and seek. Seek.
Thank the 12!
Did you find her? Did you find Minfilia?
The word of the mother? I'm not sure I understand.
Nor am I. Cryer?
As unbelievable as it sounds, I see no reason to doubt her.
The word's tale. No one was more sensitive to the will of Hydaelyn than Minfilia. And if Hydaelyn has grown so weak that she can barely make herself heard, it is not hard to see why Minfilia, having joined with her, might struggle to maintain her own form.
What? Why would she need to maintain her own form? Are you saying she's gone?
That cannot be! Not now. Not after all we have accomplished. We were meant to usher in the dawn's light together.
She threw herself on the fire to fuel your dawn's light, boy. You'll just have to usher it in on your own.
Must you be so ungentle?
Tell me about the Scions, boy.
The Scions of the Seventh Dawn lay before Eorzea's salvation. Whenever the realm is threatened, be it by Primal, Ascian, Garlean, or any other, we take up arms in her defense, that all in Eorzea may live to see a brighter tomorrow.
And that's very noble of you. But in chasing after these lofty goals of yours, you seem to have lost sight of some basic truths. To win a war, you must be willing to do whatever it takes. To fight, to kill, and if necessary, to die. The path you've chosen is paved with the dead. Walk it with your eyes open, or not at all.
I know the truth of which you speak, and have from the first. If the Ascians will go to any length to resurrect their god, then we must needs be as committed to our cause, to unmask them and their schemes, and to crush them both utterly. Come, there is much to be done.
Yes, of course.
Tancred, wait! No. No, this is all wrong.
Pleasure to see you again, my friend. I take it you received our invitation. Good, good. You of all people should be present. When the true brothers of the faith seized control of the vault, I feared the worst. Yet in adversity were we blessed with the promise of peace between man and dragon through Vidofnir's timely rescue of an innocent child. Timely, I say, though miraculous or providential might better describe the event. The gods themselves could not have devised a more fitting symbol of hope. Needless to say, we could scarce let such an opportunity pass us by. Which is why I set about making formal arrangements for a peace conference between our peoples. You and yours have done more to bring us together than any, and it is only right that you attend. But I confess, that is not the only reason I would be glad to have you there. Given Nidhogg's implacable opposition to the peace, it is possible that he and his followers may attempt to disrupt proceedings. In which event, your presence would be a comfort to all in attendance. Pray understand, I have no wish to invite the Worm's ire. But if our fractured nation is to heal, if we are to move forward as a people united, then we must do whatever is necessary to bring about lasting change. It is nothing. Lucia cautioned me against giving vent to my passions, lest my wounds reopen. It has not been easy reaching out to our opponents in Ishgard, many of whom sympathized with the actions of the True Brothers. But in so doing, we have limited the influence of the Zealots. The people are ready, my friend. This conference must go ahead. I knew you would understand. The conference will take place on the border of Ishgardian and Dravanian territory in Falcon's Nest. Lucia is there, seeing to the final preparations, even as we speak. Pray join her at your earliest convenience. Would not do for the guest of honor to arrive late, after all. Oh, and one more thing. A drink. We should make time for one. Once the conference is concluded, I mean. By my reckoning, 'tis long overdue.
Thank you. Welcome, welcome. Find yourself an empty seat and I'll be with you in a moment.
Cold out, isn't it? Here, a mug on the house. Let's get some colour back in them cheeks.
Freed food will be a bit longer than usual. We've got a lot of hungry folk to feed, what with the conference and all. Oh, so many people with cause to celebrate. To think there could be peace in our time, after all them years of fighting.
When I heard about the conference, I knew I had to come. I knew I had to be here, to do my bit. My husband, he died fighting the dragons, you see. And here we are, about to break bread with him. This was never your fight.
He walks in Halone's halls. Him and the rest of his unit.
They told me the same.
I expect they think it's comforting. Every time I come, I cry. I cannot bear to remember, but to forget would be 1,000 times worse. Yet that is what they would have us do. Accept this truth for the sake of peace. Bury the past and look to the future. But he was my future. My flesh and blood. My heart.
Is this it? We're the only ones with the courage to oppose this madness. Cowards, a lot of them. They think only of the prize, of the peace Sir Emmerich promises them. They know in their hearts it's a lie, but they go along with it anyway, desperate fools. But not I. Not I! I see the worm that killed my brother in my dreams every night. And I will not rest until he lies broken at my feet. Him and every last one of his accursed kin. All this nonsense about kings of Eld, as if I care what they did or didn't do, makes no difference to me and mine. Have the dragons sued for peace in 1,000 years? Are they bollocks?
It's a bloody ruse is what it is, and Sir Emmerich and the rest of them bloody fallen for it.
But what can we do? They believe, and naught we can say will ever change their minds. Whether we like it or not, man and dragon will come together at Falcon's Nest, and all will be forgiven. Forgiven and forgotten.
No. I will not let that happen. They will remember the true face of the enemy. I will show it to them. And we will rise up against them once more.
Hey! Hey! This is no time for napping. Do you have your wits about you? Good. Come with me. We have a crisis on our hands.
Brothers and sisters, do not be fooled by the honeyed words of the Dravarnians. The peace they promise is but a prelude to slaughter. Remember your husbands and wives never returned from war, your children torn apart by fang and claw, all your loved ones shown no mercy. Does not your heart cry out for vengeance? Your blood boil at the injustice? Remember the face of your enemy, brothers and sisters. Remember it and strike back!
You there! Don't just stand around gawping! Do something, man! Stop her!
Yes, yes, my lord.
See? See here the true nature of the highborn. With lies and deception, they lead us to our doom. And dare we raise our voices in dissent? Death is our reward. This is the choice they have given us, brothers and sisters. Death by dragon's fang, or death by nobleman's command. Death to all we hold dear. I spit on your choices, nobleman. You will take no more from me. No more. No more.
What have you done?
I only did as you ordered, my lord.
I gave no such order. I did not. I never meant for anyone to...
No, no! What have they done to you?
Is that you, my lord? You seem rather flustered. because of you, you imbecile! What in the seven hells happened to you?
My apologies. Some few of the guests expressed a wish to leave, and I implored them to stay. It would seem they took...
Your gods forgive me. If I had only been more careful with my words.
Do not blame yourself, my lord. I know. That poor woman. She lives in the past, clinging, but the future holds so much promise, so much joy. And you...
Onua?
Calm yourself. The boy will live. But it's imperative we get him inside and into...
Oh, we were so close! What? Don't they want to live in peace? Don't they want to be happy? We all want the same thing! And still it falls to pieces! Tell me, what was I supposed to do? Someone, anyone, tell me, what was I supposed to do?
Stop looking to others.
And what would you know about consequences? You who always know just what to say and just what to do. Your every deed is greeted with a round of applause.
You know nothing about me. I have fought tooth and nail for the people I hold dear. Done everything in my power to save them. Learn to live with it.
Thank you.
Lord Commander, if I may, I wish to speak with you before the Grand Melee.
Proceed.
How do you do it, my lord?
How do you lead with such certainty when so many of our countrymen will not hear of peace with the Dravanians? Some of them hate you almost as much as the dragons themselves. They decry you as a patricide in the streets. They even tried to kill you, for God's sakes. Yet still, you march on, undaunted, where no archbishop dared to tread. What is your secret? Where do you find the strength?
For centuries, our nation has been punished for the sins of our forefathers. If our punishment is to end, I believe we must right the wrongs of antiquity and move forward as a nation united. Needless to say, my father did not share this opinion. He did not believe the people strong enough to bring about their own deliverance, trusting only in himself. Tyranny seemed to him the only solution. But I have faith in the people, Lord Emanuelaine. I have faith that they will weather this storm and overcome every trial we set before them. Many have fought and died to see this blight upon our nation's history cleansed, and I would not let their sacrifices be in vain. Though we invite reprisals, the risk is worth the reward.
I want to believe. I do.
Lord Commander, through my careless orders, a pall has been cast over these proceedings, and I beg the opportunity to make amends. I, Emanuelaine de Forton, do hereby request leave to take part in the Grand Melee.
Who am I to deny such a heartfelt plea? We would be honored to have you join the fray, my lord.
You'll take charge of the Ishgardian forces.
For all my other responsibilities, I am still Lord Commander of the Temple Knights, and I would not soon yield this duty to another.
The esteemed Sir Emeric leading the Temple Knights and the Watch into battle along with my youngest. I could wish for no more.
Then you wish for too little, my lord. There is another who might yet join the fray. An indispensable ally to whom we owe much and more. An adventurer beholden to none, who nevertheless chose to champion our cause, who has shared in our suffering and in our glory. A warrior without equal, who I am privileged to call a friend. There is no one I would rather have fighting by my side. I ask this in full knowledge of your obligations, and will not think less of you should you refuse. But if your conscience will allow it, might you oblige me, my friend, one more time. Together we shall give the people a spectacle for the ages, a celebration to mark the dawning of a new era.
Thank you.